Millennium Development Goals, it was only the environment sustainability which was discussed, but immediately after this, 2004, 2005, there were very big, men in the field of international economics, which we came out, environmental sustainability is not the only issue which we should be focusing on. So Millennium Development Goals, although were discussed and then pursued for a long time, but then it was realized, the sustainability issue has to be discussed in a wider context rather than just environmental sustainability. And this wider context was divided into, let's say, three parts: economic sustainability, which had all economic aspects. Social sustainability was pointed out at this, in between people, not at the summit, but thereafter. Because during this time, there were many events around the world which were becoming a threat to social stability in many parts, in many continents. So social stability was considered to be one of the major issues which should be obtained in order to move forward in terms of achieving the global prosperity, global growth, dignity. The last, of course, was the environmental sustainability, that in order to fulfill our requirements of this development, how we should keep the relation between man and nature, or you can call it the relation between man and earth, relation between man and atmosphere, how to keep that sort of a balance. This is also a major issue. So after dividing these the challenges into three categories, there was another conference then, wider thinking, in the implementation of this Millennium Development Goals. They were revived or reviewed in 2010, 2013, 2014 in various, I'm not going into the details of those meetings and conferences, but what happened in 2016, it was realized, by the way, the Millennium Development Goals, which were formulated in 2000, they were all these eight goals, Millennium Goals, which I had mentioned, had specific targets of reducing poverty, reducing hunger, reducing unemployment, reducing gender, in terms of fixed targets, in terms of, let's say, figures, percentages, how much poverty would be reduced, how much hunger would be reduced. And the target year for this Millennium Development Goal was 2015. By 2010, it was realized that we are nowhere, not only achieving these targets and goals, we are perhaps lagging behind, we are going back on the various commitments that the countries have made. For example, the G8 countries, all the developed countries in Millennium Development Goals, had made a commitment of about, let's say, $50 billion for achieving these eight goals which were there in Millennium Development Goals. But this, unfortunately, this money was not utilized for achieving these goals, which were declared in Millennium Development Goals. They were mostly used in meeting the debt of some of the countries, which were in good faith of the these countries, and also some remaining money was used for disaster relief provided to these countries in major disasters. So as a matter of fact, the commitment which was made by the rich countries for achieving goals for these, for equality, justice and accountability, they were not used for the purpose, actual purpose. And the failure of this led the thinkers or the policy makers, I would say, to have another set of goals. In 2016, the United Nations came up with a new set of goals. These are now related with sustainability of every aspect of the world economy. Sustainability of every aspect of the world economy. And these are known as Sustainable Development Goals. Earlier they were called Millennium Development Goals. Now they are Sustainable Development Goals, given in 2016. And keeping in mind the scope of these challenges, which is going beyond what we thought in 2000 were the issues, and now the issues are sort of widening or becoming very large. So the Sustainable Development Goals had a list of 17 goals instead of 8 goals. And each of these goals had a number of targets. So these are 17 goals with 169 targets defined explicitly. And again, the date of this achieving these goals and targets, which earlier in Millennium Development Goals were 2015, now it was rescheduled that Sustainable Development Goals and its targets should be achieved by 2030. You can call it as Vision 2030 of the World Economy, Sustainable Development Goals. Now, if I have to just enumerate these things, most of the Millennium Development Goals are there, but the one which have sort of very challenging are also incorporated here. So first of all, the first goal was no poverty in any form, and hunger, and then you have to focus on good health and well-being of people, quality education, gender equality, then there was a focus on clean water and sanitation, then you have the use of affordable clean energy, which is one very major part related to the Millennium Development Goal, which was related to the environmental sustainability. Now the important point in these Sustainable Development Goals has been a provision of decent work and economic growth. Provision of decent work. Now, this is a challenge which every country now, whether developed and developing country, is facing, including our own country, how to provide a decent, dignified job to our population, especially to the educated youth. Reducing inequalities, of course, is one major issue. Inequalities are rising all over the world, whether they are developed countries, whether they are developing countries. It's a relative kind of phenomenon. And there is a focus now on the problems of cities and communities. There is also a focus whether the consumption patterns and the production patterns that the world is leading to are really sustainable or not sustainable. Climate change, of course, remains one issue. There is a new dimension attached to these goals, is about the blue economy, which is the life below waters, I mean, in the seas. So the sea economy, which is of course leading to many other problems in the all oceans. Life of land, on land, is related with our forestry, etc. And number 16 is very important. This is where our focus is on the conference. That's how to take care of this peace, justice, and how to build institutions for keeping peace and justice in the world economy. That is there as one of the goals. It is to be achieved by 2030 now, if it has not been achieved. And then finally, we have to again, like Millennium Development Goals, we have to develop a global partnership in order to achieve all these goals. So challenges are increasing, and even with the build-up of many institutions, probably so far the history tells us that we are not able to not only meet the goals, but we are in many of the these dimensions, including equality and justice, we are lagging. We are moving backward, moving forward. This is the realization, and we have to live with this reality and work for really building up more institutions at the global level and at the national level. We have this to do this. Thank you very much.